She'll be fine.
Shh. Yeah, you tell her. I didn't shush her.
Not being funny, but I'm not spending my morning sunny being quiet. So
right.
Gone.
Welcome back to Brendan Pearson Fitness. We're joined by professional gamer, Joe. We brought her. Anyway, so we're outside today. We're going to take you through a little bit of an off-season leg workout, specifically for a footballer. So we're going to be working a bit of speed, a bit of agility, and a bit of power. Go inside in the gym and then work on some leg strength, some hypertrophy work, and yeah, just a little off-season workout that you can do. So it seems the season's probably not going to be until start of July, pre-season maybe even delayed a little bit further. Now's the time to kind of put in the heavy work, get some explosive strength leg work in while you can, and then kind of progress into more cardio stuff down the line. But anyway, we've warmed up.
Do you count how many times Brendan moves his hands?
Enthusiastic.
Right, anyway. So we've warmed up in the gym, bike, mobility, did some Copenhagen's because we've both got bad groins.
Very bad.
Copenhagen's. Done a bit of a jog, bits and bobs. So we're starting off the session. We've got speed exercise, which is going to be flying 20s. Don't know how long this thing is, but we probably won't be able to do them properly. So what you want to do is a 20-yard gentle jog into a 20-yard sprint. That's what you ideally want to do, but we'll probably just do like 10-yard jog into like 15 or 20-yard sprint, whatever we can do. I'll measure it out with some cones. So we'll start off with that. Go into some agility. We're going to do zigzag runs, which is literally just out to the side, back across. You'll see anyway. And then we're going to do just some counter movement jumps, which is just some leg strength, jumping up and down. So pretty basic, covering all the areas, and then we'll head in the gym. But oh, yes, shout out Jack. I keep shouting him out. He's never gonna see this, is he?
He might like.
Well, Jack, can I have some of your followers, please? I'm representing. Up the towel, though. Right. I'll set this up. We've had to make do with 10-yard jog, 15-yard sprint, because we're limited, but that's what we're going to do. We'll warm up, we'll do about 3 or 4 maybe warm up ones, probably just 3. We'll go at like 70%, 80%, 90%, and then we'll go to 6 sets of 100% max. Right, so a bit of speed done. Now I'm going to do agility, so a little zigzag run. It's literally 1, 2, 3, 4 cones, and then a little 5-yard dash at the end. Just running around the cones as quick as you can, change the direction, pushing off that foot, planting, change direction as quick as you can. We'll just go straight into it because we're pretty warm. 3 one side, and then we'll go from the reverse because you're working the other side. Good little blow, especially when it's like this. So working these explosive movements, transfer obviously over to the pitch because you're constantly changing direction. Don't always do things in a straight line, mix it up side to side. Some good little bits of conditioning as well, and then also doing your stuff in the gym, leg strength stuff, especially lateral lunges, squats, split squats will help with that transfer of energy from eccentric to pushing off. So we'll work on that stuff in the gym, but we've got just 6 reps of counter movement jumps. I don't mind, but just use your hands for momentum. Just squat down, jump as high as you can. About 30 seconds rest again in between, 6 times. But catch your breath. That's decent, actually. That's not too bad.
Mine was higher than that, wasn't it, Mum?
I'm 100 kilograms. Right, six sets done, the outside work done. Now we're inside for strength squat work. Let's go. Right, back in the gym. So just a quick point as well, the reason we've done our speed, agility, power stuff first is because for athletes, that's the priority. The gym work is just put on the back burner because the focus is the stuff that you're going to be doing out on the pitch. So off-season, do your power work, do your speed, agility stuff, the things that you're prioritising. If you're prioritising getting fitter, prioritise the running first, or do that early in the day, do your weights later. If you're prioritising strength, do that early in the day and do your endurance stuff after. So we want to get quicker, faster, we'll do that first. I know it's going to impact our strength work, but that's the priority. So we're doing that first in the gym. We are on, so the athlete build program is front squat. It's actually programmed back squats, but I prefer front squats for athletes. If you have any back issues or if you are in season, I wouldn't be loading your spine, so no back squats, no front squats. I would be doing split squats or trap bar deadlifts when you're holding the weight down your side. So it's off season, so you can do it. But Joel, because you haven't back squat before, you're going to be doing goblet squats, so just in that position. Doing the exact same thing that I'm doing in a front squat, it's just a lighter weight and it's a little bit safer, less load on the spine. It just teaches you the technique because I haven't read them before. So front squats, 4x2, building the weight up each set into a top set of two, pushing pretty close to failure, keeping the explosiveness throughout the sets. Then into eccentric sets, which are nice and slow on the way down, so almost 5 seconds, 4 or 5 seconds on the way down, explode that up, 3 sets of 2, again, increasing the weight each time. And then box squats, which is just a reduced range of motion. So you're coming down to the box and exploding back up, but you'll see what we're doing anyway. Brendan underscore Connor on Mixcloud, just seeing old mixes. Alright, go on, try and back squat that, Jolson.
Easy.
Well, yeah. They've now used these new iPhones, like, I'm doing this. Right. Anyway, so we've done a 4 sets of 2. 4 sets of 2 done. Now we're doing 3 sets of 2, but with a 4 second eccentric. So drop the weight about 5 or 10 kilograms, depending on how heavy you're lifting. Nice and controlled down, explode up. 3 sets. Working eccentric. So these carry over onto the pitch. So when you're eccentrically lowering, so when you're changing direction, you're eccentrically lowering that way to push off, we're just building that strength eccentrically. Right, we're going to get into it. In terms of rest periods, you can literally rest as much as you need for the strength stuff because the quality in the rep needs to be perfect, so each set needs to be maximal. So if you need to take 5 minutes just for your top sets, in between your kind of build up sets. What the fuck am I doing now? I don't want to do that. Catch. Yeah, so in between your build-up sets, you can probably take a minute and a half, 2 minutes. That top set, so maybe your third set, going into your fourth, rest as long as you need to make sure the quality is right. Blow it up.
up. Do five.
And slip.
Oh, it's gone. Oh. Oh.
That's the heavy portion done. Gonna do some hypertrophy work now. We've got lying hamstring curls with the Swiss ball or the gym ball, 3 sets of 10. Tell you what, we'll superset that with the dumbbell walking lunges. We'll head outside.
That was lovely,
aren't they?
That's what I want to be doing.
It's nice, like, we'll just go back to back. So cut the rest times down on this, maximum 2 minutes. If you're short of a time, superset them, so I think we'll just superset them because the session's been quite long. Finishing off, dumbbell walking lunges, 10 up, 10 back, so 10 either leg. And then gym ball hamstring curls or metaphysical bridges, we'll see. 10, 10, the other partner goes, 3 rounds. Oh, the exit that slippy, I can't put my hand on it. 3 rounds I've done. And now we're just gonna move on to prone cobra holds. So we'll do 60 seconds each, just back to back, 3 rounds. So a minute on, minute off. Just keeping the chest off the floor, legs off the floor, squeezing the glutes. Good little finisher for the hammies, glutes, lower back.
What the fuck's that?
Five seconds, like, squeeze my phone, come on, squeeze it, go on, burst it. 3, 2, 1,
oh.
Time. Brown bread. You're broken.
I'm a broken man.
Oh. So, session done. That was a long one. I'm tired now. I'm hungry, very hungry. But there's a little off-season workout. Obviously, you don't have to do the additional hypertrophy bit. If you're focusing purely on strength and power, just split the strength stuff up, still do the cobras at the end. But that's just a little example. So we've done our speed, agility, power. Then we did our strength stuff, some eccentric strength stuff, and then some limited range of movement stuff with the box. Hypertrophy focus, just 3 sets of lunges with the gym ball curls. And then court finish. And then don't forget mobility. But I'm gonna stretch, cool off. Do you wanna do the outro, pal?
What now?
Yes, go on, you're on.
If you want to see more content from Brennan Pierce Fitness, please like and subscribe. Over and out, pop pickers.
Fantastic. Over and out.
Rabbit! Brennan Pearson, number one, goalkeeper.
Slap you in your coffee, mate. Brr. The buttercream, that. Brr. Brr. The buttocks.
Himmene, himmene, himmene.